I'm Sister John Dominic. I'm a Dominican sister of Mary, Mother of the Eucharist, and I'm in Ann Arbor, Michigan. So if you like the Michigan Wolverines, go blue.
My name is Mother Anne Marie. I'm a Marian sister from the Diocese of Lincoln, Nebraska. We are a Franciscan group with a true devotion to the Blessed Mother. We express this in teaching, nursing, social work, or anything that the Lord might ask us to do.
Hi, my name is Sister Serena, and I'm a Marian sister from the Diocese of Lincoln, Nebraska. That is in the middle of the United States, for those of you out here wondering. We're the flyover states. Yeah.
My name is Reverend Mother Teresa Christe. I'm a founding member of the Marian Sisters of Santa Rosa. Our community members are devoted to magnifying Jesus Christ in union with Mary, His Holy Mother. By communicating the beauty, goodness, and truth of our Catholic faith while we live the fullness of the liturgical life.
My name is Sister Margaret Mary. I am a part of the Marian Sisters of Santa Rosa.
And I'm Sister Mary Emmanuel.
When I first started thinking about being a religious sister, I was probably fairly young. Second or third grade, our principal would always come around to the classroom, and she was a religious, and say, you know, raise your hand if you want to be a religious sister. And everybody would raise their hand because it's second grade. But as we got older, less and less hands, but still in eighth and ninth grade, I was definitely still thinking about being a religious sister.
I would say I was in my mid-teens when I first thought of being a sister.
I'm a convert, so one of my first exposures to sisters was when I was a freshman in high school. So when I first thought of it, probably wasn't until I was a junior, so I don't know what the age, maybe 16 or 17. So that's, it kind of like came in, I thought, maybe this is what the Lord's calling me to do. But it wasn't something I kind of grew up thinking about.
When I first thought of being a religious sister, I was a junior in college. I went to public school my whole life growing up, and then I transferred my junior year of college to Benedictine College, which is a Catholic school, and that's the same year that Marian Sisters started sending sisters there. And it was really from just hearing a priest homily, and I felt like he had read me my life. And it was at that moment that I was like, I think God's calling me to be a nun, but I did not know what that meant. I mean, I saw the Marian Sisters, but still I liked them, but it wasn't like, woo, let me go be one of them. So yeah, I was kind of older, if you will, when I first thought about it.
It has been 7 years since I entered the convent now.
5 years for me.
I have been in religious vows for 21 years.
Nearly 40 years.
I've been here 18 years.
I entered religious life in 1982, so if you could do some mental math really quick, you can figure that out. So it's almost 40 years that I've been in religious life.
To be a religious sister means to be completely consecrated to Jesus Christ, to be His 24/7, and we are a mother of souls, a daughter of the church, and a spouse of Jesus Christ.
Be a religious sister is really one of the greatest graces that you can have, you know, because for us, it's a personal relationship, and we are brides of Christ, and we've been called to this intimate relationship where our hearts belong solely to Christ. And what happens is that the whole world, so even though I'm not seeing you right now, who's watching this, okay, you become a part of our spiritual family.
To be a religious sister means that we have dedicated our life to Jesus. He is our spouse, He is our everything. We pray for Him, we work for Him, we recreate and we have fun for Him. So we do everything in our life for Him.
The whole thing.
Agreed.
But truly, probably to know that I belong to Christ, I am His, and no matter what, I can trust in that relationship and trust that he will never abandon me.
My favorite part about being a religious sister is having Jesus in the home, having the Blessed Sacrament there. Because in the middle of the night, if I get up, you can always just go say hi to him. That really is my favorite part.
Being able to share a common life together, that we have the same, we're going in the same direction, you know. As Dominicans, we're following in the footsteps of St. Dominic, our charism. We come together in prayer during the day. We recreate together. We play games. We play soccer. We play basketball. We go for bike rides. We study together. We eat our meals together. And it's just really just the joy of knowing that I'm living out my vocation, surrounded by, in my case, many beautiful women that are seeking the same thing.
My favorite part about being a religious sister is that I don't have to do it by myself. I love the community aspect. We bring each other up, we bring each other along. And I'm having a bad day, I can rejoice in the joys of my sisters. We can celebrate with each other and just take joy in the Lord loving each of us individually.
My favorite part of being a religious sister is all the time that I get to be with Jesus exclusively, and also to be with all those whom Jesus loves most. First of all, my own sisters, but then all those souls that we work with in our apostolates.
One of my favorite stories is I was shopping with my mom, and it was around Thanksgiving, and I was kind of lagging behind, just looking at different things. And there was also this other family who had kids, and this one boy was kind of lagging behind as well. And finally, he came up to me and he goes, "Are you a pilgrim?" So I looked at him, I go, "No, I'm a nun." And my mom goes, "She's a sister." As if he's gonna know the difference. He thought I was a pilgrim. I don't know, the Mayflowers parked out back? I don't know how to respond to that.
When I was in novitiate, which means I was a new sister and I had the white veil and I had my new name, I had the opportunity almost every night to have a Eucharistic holy hour, just Jesus and I in the middle of the night. And every night that I was called to chapel to do that, some nights were more difficult than others because I was very tired or something, but I would always start the holy hour with singing Jesus a special song from the Mass, called the Veni Sancte Spiritus. It's a special song that's sung to our Lord during the Mass on the Feast of Pentecost, and it was one of my favorite. And so I would start my holy hour in this lonely chapel with this little song just to Jesus, and so from that time on, it's become one of our favorite songs to exchange with one another.
Oftentimes you'll see people will stop and ask to take a picture or wave, or sometimes you'll see people like taking a selfie and trying to be nonchalant, like they pretending that they aren't. So it's just kind of funny. But my favorite reaction was one day I was walking down the street, a busier street, and a man on a motorcycle, when he saw me, he made the sign of the cross. And it struck me because I realized that he wasn't noticing me, Sister Mary Emanuel, the person that I am, but he was seeing a sister, a bride of Christ. And that seeing that sister made him realize that God was present in his midst. And that's what my name means, Mary Emanuel, is God with us. And so just that moment that he recognized that God is here, that was like amazing that God could walk among us in me.
Sometimes I'm asked, is it difficult to be a sister? And I say, yes, it's difficult because when you follow, I mean, we can't expect anything different. You know, when we follow Jesus Christ, he said, it's gonna be the narrow way. You're gonna follow him, we're gonna follow this path of the cross. And another thing to remember when we talk about it, you know, 1 John 2:6, that when we follow Jesus, that we need to walk everywhere that he's walked. So there are going to be times where there's sorrow, there's going to be times when there's joy. And what do you do when, what I do when it's difficult, I just go before the Blessed Sacrament, I go to Jesus. And I take my worries, my concerns, and I just imagine if you could, you could think about this too, because I know many of you all may have anxieties or things that you get worried about. You know, find a church, find Jesus, go to adoration, and just pour it all out and leave it in the tabernacle. You know, just imagine like you kind of like sneak it inside that door of the tabernacle and you close it and you just leave it there with Jesus and say, Jesus, help me as I carry these burdens and these difficulties.
I think that it is always, there are always difficulties in following one's vocation. And everyone has a vocation of some sort or another. So one will always have some difficulties. And the difficulties aren't there to make us depressed or minimize our commitment, but they're there to challenge it and make it more deep and noble and more loving. So whenever I come upon some difficulties, I just think about, how can I deepen my love? What is God asking me in this particular situation? And then to really pick up that cross and follow Him.
It's never difficult to be a sister. It's perfect.
Yes, there are days when it is hard sometimes to be a sister, especially when you live with a community of women, because we all have our own ideas, our own opinions. And so there you have to learn a lot of give and take. And that's where rubber hits the road, because you learn that love, it's not in the feelings, it's in I will the good of the other. But when it is difficult, yes, I will talk to maybe my superior about what's going on, or just another trusted sister in the community, or my own spiritual director. But ultimately, I have to be honest in prayer with Jesus of saying, this is really hurting, and to give it over to Him.
One thing that I would say is that it is possible. Don't think that, oh, God would never choose me, or I'm not good enough for that. God will give you the grace. If it is your vocation, God will give you the grace, and you will find the greatest happiness in that life that you could ever imagine.
If a young woman is thinking about religious life, I would encourage them to become very serious about their own prayer life. Get a spiritual director, to attend Mass daily, if not more than just on Sundays, to be a little bit more involved in their parish level as far as things that they can do to get involved. So being involved in the life of the church will help you just get a general sense of what the church is and where your call is within that.
What we have to do when we're considering religious life is to begin reading the lives of the saints who were religious, because you can receive great encouragement from that. To really look at your life and say, where can I add more prayer into my daily life? And that's not just the prayer that we say when we're on a walk or something, but some actual time set aside to get to know and love God more by prayer. And that prayer could be the rosary, it could be the liturgy of the hours. I think it's a good idea to let your parish priest know and see if they have any advice for you. You can even ask that question in confession and ask the priest if there's any advice he could give to someone who feels that they might be called by God.
Know yourself and then look at the other options that are out there and then go visit. You know, go visit them, right? But let me just say one little thing. Don't spend forever and ever and ever thinking about what you're going to do, right? You know, so there's three parts of prudence. Okay, prudence is, one is good counsel, so you ask people, you get advice. The next is good judgment, so you make a decision. And the last thing is command. And the command is you make a decision and you do it, right? So don't spend forever and ever and ever and ever think about it, right? Look about it, know yourself, visit them if you're happy, then take that next step and go visit and have a more intense, you know, and join. You know, that's the only way you're going to know is spend time with the sisters.